We've seen things, heard things that don't make sense. Spent countless hours investigating the paranormal in search of answers. This is No Nonsense Paranormal.
The Ohio State Reformatory's cornerstone was laid November 4th, 1886. The first 150 young offenders arrived September 1896. After housing over 150,000 men in its lifetime, the prison closed December 31st, 1990. While in Mansfield that day, we took the self-guided tour of the Ohio State Reformatory. Walk through the entire structure. These are the pictures that we took. For us, that night, all roads led to the Fire Museum investigation. These are the photos we took while on our walkthrough with Mr. Shook. There are pieces of equipment and apparatus in the museum that date back to 1837. The Fire Museum has put in a replica of Main Street in the early 1950s, along with a fully restored soda jerk shop, which this shop will wind up being crucial in our investigation later tonight. From the Mansfield State Prison, this room also will be a big part of our investigation tonight. We start off our investigation with a baseline reading.
First round at the Fire Museum.
Can you shut that door?
Well, or tell JS to at least.
Here we are at the Mansfield Fire Museum on March 3rd, 2018. This will be our first go around in the museum.
Okay.
Anybody wish to speak to us tonight? My name's Brian. Everybody calls me Tiny. I've been a volunteer firefighter for 15 years. I am one of your brothers. I do believe the red line. Know what it's like to look the dragon in the eye. Know what it's like to pull a life from the hands of the Grim Reaper. I would like for you to communicate with me. Can you make a sound for me? Let me know what room you're in so I can come talk to you. Through the educational part of the Fire Museum. This part of the museum is dedicated to providing fire prevention for adults and children. Who is this museum dedicated to? It's quite an honor to investigate this building. So much history in this one place, from the mid-1800s up. Is there any spirits that wish to communicate with us from any of those time frames? J.S., Mr. Bob Shook, and his friends join in the investigation. Can you touch this device in my hand? If you touch it, it'll make a noise like this. Can you touch that for me? It won't hurt you, it won't bother you. Just touch it and it'll let me know that you're here. Can you give me the name of one of the previous chiefs? What was your house number? What engine company or ladder company was you with?
Do you have any kids? Can you tell us how many?
This is EVP's a bitch too.
I'm
Nick's listening for EVP's a bitch too.
I don't really mind that.
Yeah, actually, it comes out pretty good. You'd be surprised.
I just don't like it when I'm on board, but since we're in the city, it picks up his radio station. Yeah, yeah. It's so much better. If we were out in the country or something like that, it'd be a little bit more.
A battleship.
More battleship. All right. There might be a little bit of feedback on this, like before. We'll run the echo box. We'll try to keep the squeal out of there so it doesn't break everybody's eardrums.
That's what it sounds like.
While on our walkthrough with Mr. Shook, Mr. Shook spoke of a spirit that was looking for his long-lost love. His name was Donnie.
Say, I'm sorry?
What's your favorite furniture?
Love you?
Is Donnie and his love together in death?
As soon as I said Bob, something said, yep.
You can say his last name. What is the name of the gentleman that runs the museum? His last name. That was pretty close, you should.
Yeah.
Do you like Mr. Shook?
What does Mr. Shook do that you don't like?
What? What?
Is this because Mr. Shook locks the building up at night?
I heard one
What other buildings in Mansfield is haunted?
Man.
That said man.
Did you hear Papa?
There's too many people talking at once, one person at a time. Can I speak to the male? Donnie, is that you?
What was that?
It sounded like a cat register.
Was that you, Tiny?
The glass is chinging together.
Yeah, that wasn't you?
I'm standing in the window of the register.
I thought it was a cat register.
I'm right beside the register.
I thought it sounded like two glasses clinking together.
There it is again.
Yeah. What the?
If you're behind there, can you give me a soda, please?
What's the tracks outside the house? You hear that?
I just heard it.
It said Bisman. Plain as fucking day, it said Bisman.
Oh, I thought I heard call them. Is that what it
did?
I swear it said Bisman.
Something, Brad? I'm coming to you.
What's the book in front of me?
If I can stand up.
Book. What is this book in front of me?
Book. What? Right.
just about all the way down on the right. I know it's... It could be the statue of the...
How many people's in this room?
Firefighter. But the light between its legs down there keeps changing. Like getting blacked out.
My focus is changing and I'm not touching the focus.
Like it's moving.
Give me the name of someone in this room. Brad.
Yeah, I heard it.
Speak. What do you want to say to Brad?
Brad, you said Brad and speak. What do you want Brad to say?
Did Brad and JS just see the spirit? And then the spirit took responsibility by saying, that was me? And then asked Brad to speak?
You want me to ask some questions? Can you tell us where these pews came from?
I can sit there now.
If I was to stand right here on Sunday, what would I be doing?
Bursting the flames.
Did it just say pulpit?
No, it did.
I think it just said pulpit.
Okay, you know Brad's name. Can you tell us the rest of our names?
Michael.
I thought I heard Tiny.
I heard Michael.
Michael was plain as day. There's no one in here, Michael, that's alive. Is Michael with us that's not here, has passed away? Was Michael a deceased firefighter?
He burned?
Was Michael a fireman or a citizen that had perished?
Did Michael die in a house fire?
Slow down.
Was Michael a line of duty death?
I just heard John. It almost sounded like a computer generated voice, though.
Wasn't a bang. I'm sorry, that little noise that happened right after he said it, I said that wasn't a bang. You hear that? Who's walking around with us? We welcome you to. Just kind of like to know who you are. Maybe tell us your name.
Can you ring one of the bells?
That would be cool.
Pull that firebox over there in the other room. Did you have a Dalmatian? What was his name if you had one?
Excuse me. I don't know why, but all of a sudden I feel a lot more creeped out. Anybody else?
I've been pretty creeped out most of the night, really.
It's the first time I felt it all night. Thing.
Okay, I just heard something between you and me.
Great.
Whisper right in my ear.
Well, hopefully we got it on audio. Did you hear me say that all of a sudden I'm a lot more creeped out than I was earlier?
Yeah.
Or than I have been all night, either one of you guys? I was standing that close to that thing. It scared the hell out of me.
Can any of you gentlemen come out and talk to us?
Pretty please. This one has badges on it.
That's a traditional pickhead axe.
Thing is just wicked.
That's just,
this is more like almost like a battle axe.
No, that's why I like it.
There's some audio contamination.
Yes, you think?
That's how I'll get him out of here.
Great Britain. Leeds. Norwich. Norwich.
No Nonsense Paranormal would like to thank the Mansfield Fire Museum and Mr. Bobby Shook for our investigation this night. We recommend you come to this location for your investigation. Here's the contact information for Mr. Shook.